This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Monday, the 7th day of May in the year 2018. Here's what we're tracking tonight. A joint services investigative team that probed the June 2008 murder of 8 miners at Lindo Creek is being called upon to provide reasons why it did not interview any civilian before it completed its probe and offered its findings. And the report from the investigation, which lasted just about 2 weeks, cleared the joint services of any blameworthiness. But the chairman of the ongoing Commission of Inquiry, Justice Donald Trotman, was particularly concerned that no civilian was interviewed as part of the probe. And he raised that concern this morning.
Didn't your team think it necessary to have Mr. Orokem interviewed? Especially because Mr. Orokem, as the team was aware, was making allegations concerning the joint services, which included the GDF and the police.
Appearing before the Commission of Inquiry today to answer those questions was Guyana Defense Force Major Andy Pompey, who back in 2008 headed the investigating team. At that time, Pompey held the rank of Commanding Officer for Intelligence. Major Pompey said those interviewed included two GDF pilots and members of the A and B teams who were carrying out joint services operations in the area at the time.
Throughout our investigation, The members of the teams who were operating at between the Kokwana and Ashni areas, sir, those were the only persons that my team was permitted to interview, sir. The team did not have the prerogative to go and interview other persons, so only those persons were permitted for us to interview. Members of the team and the team and the pilots.
The Joint Services Investigating Team had concluded that the allegations of murder against ranks were pure speculation, and it also noted that all arms and ammunition were presented and accounted for. The team was given 10 terms of reference along with 8 other areas of investigation to address, Major Pompey told the commission. Turning now to that deadly pirate attack in neighboring Suriname. That attack, which has left 15 Guyanese fishermen dead, will likely come up in Guyana's National Assembly for discussion at the next sitting. Opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo intends to bring the issue up as he intends to ask the government to offer help to the families of the fishermen. Mr. Jagdeo met with some of the relatives of the fishermen last evening in Suriname and said the attack which took place in that country is exceptional and the Guyana government's response should also be exceptional and not lukewarm. He classified the attack as an act of terrorism and called upon both the governments of Guyana and Suriname to work collaboratively and swiftly in addressing the horrific incidents fully and comprehensively. He also urged that the full force of the law be used to bring the perpetrators to justice. Public Security Minister Kemraj Ramjetan is also in Suriname along with a Guyana Police Force team. He has been meeting with Surinamese government officials to get updates on the investigations and to better understand the attack. He has also been meeting with family members of the men who were killed. 20 fishermen were attacked 2 Fridays ago and thrown overboard by the pirates in the Surinamese waters. All of the suspects arrested so far are all Guyanese nationals. 3 suspects have been arrested in Guyana, while several others, including the mastermind, have been arrested in neighboring Suriname. Turning our attention now to the courts, former Finance Minister Dr. Ashni Singh and former head of NISIL Winston Brassington were once again not present in court today, as the charges for misconduct in public office was once again called against them. This time, however, a high-level team of lawyers entered appearances for the 2 former government officials. The charges against the 2 men who served under the former PP civic government are related to the sale of state lands at prices that were found to be far below the value. The attorneys now representing Singh and Brassington are Ronald Bird Smith, Stanley Moore, Sage Gunraj, and Mark Waldron. Dr. Singh and Brassington both live outside of Guyana now. The case was today adjourned until tomorrow, Tuesday, with the chief magistrate asking the prosecution for a return of the summons to satisfy her that efforts were made to serve the summons at the accused's last known addresses. The charges were brought against Dr. Singh and Mr. Brassington by the Special Organized Crime Unit. Last week, the High Court refused to grant an interim order to halt the case brought against Dr. Ashni Singh and Brassington for alleged misconduct in public office. even as it proceeds to hear an application for dismissal of the charges. Still in the courts, 1 week after a Sophia resident claimed self-defense as he stabbed an alleged bird thief to death, he found himself before the courts facing a manslaughter charge today. 56-year-old Peter Jansen appeared in the courtroom of the chief magistrate this morning, where the unlawful killing charge was read to him. He was not required to enter a plea to the indictable charge, which stated that on the 1st of May he unlawfully killed Shelton Jordan. The man's attorney made an application for bail, citing the fact that his client had a right to defend himself, knowing that the situation was life-threatening. The magistrate granted bail in the sum of $280,000, and the accused will make his next court appearance on the 28th of May. Last Tuesday morning, Jansen was out on an early morning walk with his pet bird when the youth rode up alongside him on a motorcycle and snatched the cage with the bird. The two got into a scuffle and the youth allegedly pulled a knife on the man. It was at that stage that Jansen reportedly relieved the young man of the knife and used it to repeatedly stab him to the body. The alleged bird thief was left to die on the roadway. Jansen was arrested just after and a full investigation was conducted. And finally this evening, 24-year-old unlicensed driver Ronald Balgobin was today sentenced to 4 years in jail after he pleaded guilty to causing the death of two persons by dangerous driving. The accused stood before the chief magistrate at a Georgian magistrate's court and took full responsibility for the deaths. The court heard it on the 13th of April at Land of Canaan. Balgobin drove minibus BWW4542 in a manner dangerous to the public, causing the death of passengers Ramrup Persaud and Evan Mohan. On the day of the accident, the young driver was heading south along the Land of Canaan public road when he lost control of the bus, causing it to topple several times. Before the sentence was handed down, Balgobin explained to the court that on the day in question, the owner of the bus insisted that he work the bus that day since the regular driver was unavailable. He explained that he was overtaking a truck when he lost control of the minibus and it toppled him. He asked the court for mercy, but the magistrate sentenced him to 4 years in jail for each death. However, the two jail sentences will run concurrently. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting.